Alright, second video on the tilt jig for the front. So I got that done. I put a couple extra supports in there. But just to recap, I got the back on already, which you guys already saw. That's done. Of course, the car is still on the jacks. So we got the support here on the right, and then the front here, we've got a 4x4 here that is hooked up to the front main body mount here, and right in here. So I've got a bolt that goes all the way through that 4x4, and then through that 4x4 here are two bolts that go in through the 4x4 and bolted in the back, same here, which holds this vertical 2x4, and then these three bolts here and here hold on to the horizontal, which holds the plywood and the leg there and leg there. Here's view from this side, and a view from this side. So the way I've designed it is that these are identical distances from the car itself. So here in the front, here I got my center line of the car here, and the equal distances from the center line out to here, and the same here to here as I did in the back. Center line here, equal distance from here to here. So then when this thing goes and tilts over, each leg is exactly the same. So it should come over smoothly and it won't twist on me. Because if this one comes in shorter, it'll give it a little twist, or if that one's shorter, however which way it is. When the car comes, it's going to give it a funky twist to it. So when you design these, you got to make sure that these are equal heights, also off the ground too as well. So we've got a 2-foot radius for these rotations and 2 feet radius for these. So the legs here are exactly 24 inches, exact 24 inches from here over. So here's my radius point. So it's pretty low in the car, just like the other side. We want to keep the top side heavy so that when we flip it over, legs will catch it and won't come back on me. And then I put this extra plywood here to keep this thing from doing this and that. And then I think that's it. I did notice I'm missing. Oh, yep. Mendy plate here. I gotta get that on there. And that's it. I did have to move it out a little bit. I was afraid it was too close. I put these, the 2x4 gap here just to get a good distance away from the car, in case this thing kind of gives a little bit for any reason. It shouldn't, but at least I can get in there. If I need to do any cleaning, I can get my hands in there. And then I got plenty of distance here. Actually almost too much. It comes up from the car pretty good. You know, you've probably got a good 8 inches or so from the car. But when you move it, it's pretty darn sturdy. So, I'm gonna lower down off the jacks, take it down, and set it on its feet, and give it a whirl, clean up a little bit, and I may not turn it today. I don't have any help today. But maybe turn it later. I may take these dollies here and put one under each leg just so that I can move it around for now until I can get somebody else to help me tip this over and make sure this thing's working. All right, that's it.